main, which is also an exit point. See, when I run the application, the program starts executing instructions. The first instruction in our code which is executed is the first line of main, and the last instruction which is executed is the last line of main. In this case, of course, we have only one. So we can say main is an entry point and also the exit point. Main is an entry and exit point, both for an application. Now, what is the importance of this string array? See, in today's date, when everything is graphics, GUI, with the Vista operating system already there, supporting excellent graphics, how are we going to justify the development of console-based application? What kind of situation are we talking about when we develop console-based applications? Yes, we are going to develop console-based applications even today when there are a lot of graphical applications around. Generally, console-based applications are not very interactive, but then they are very useful whenever we want to develop an application which we want to execute as a child process from another parent process. Say for example, I have a GUI application which has to provide some backup. The GUI application has to take some inputs from the user, probably something like directory in which the backup should be created, the file which has to be backed up, or any other information for that matter. You have a GUI application, and somebody also wants to take the backup by directly running a console-based application. So we can have two type of situations now. One wants to take a backup, so they can run a utility at command prompt, a console-based application, or they can run a GUI application, which everybody can have their own interface as they want and take a backup. I'm sure this is a little confusion. Let me explain a little more in detail. See, console-based application limitation is non-interactive, but a Windows-based application advantage is very interactive, very friendly. Now, I want to provide to you a program which you should be able to use it as it is without any modification. Now, if I give you a GUI application, don't you think my GUI screen would not necessarily synchronize with your GUI screen? It may or may not synchronize. That's a real big problem. I might give background color as gray to my application, and you might say the background color of the window for your application is white. Somebody else says, I want to have a colorful application, so they might go for something like yellow. So it becomes really asynchronous. So what probably the best way of distributing application can be, I give you a console-based application, which you develop a GUI application with your own interface, and launch my console-based application as another process, and it does not have any user interface of itself. All the GUI will be of your application. Your application would then provide input to my application in the form of some command line arguments. So that's where the main has this string array parameter. So console-based applications, the best way of providing input is in the form of command line arguments. These command line arguments I can give at command prompt and execute. These command line arguments can be provided by a parent process which is using this console-based application as a child process. So now, for the time being, we are not concerned about developing a parent process and launching this as a child process. For now, we are interested in how to use these command line arguments and how to provide these command line arguments, both the things. There are two aspects of it. So let us say now I replace this C# and I put here plus, which is concatenation operator, args of 0. See, what is args here? As we can note here, args is a string array, that is array of arguments, array of string. So whenever we are giving command line arguments, it's going to be considered here as string array. If there are no command line arguments, the length of this array will be 0. But there are command line arguments given. Args of 0 will be first command line argument. Args of 1 will be second command line arguments. Args of 2 will be third command line argument, and so on. So now I have given hello args of 0. And we as of now know that we have not given any command line arguments. Let us run the application. Debug start without debugging. Hereafter, I'm not going to use this menu option. I'll run whenever I want to run the application. I'll use this shortcut Ctrl plus F5. So you see now this is a problem. So I can say check, close the program, and I say here whatever is the program. Index out of range exception. Index was out of bounds of the array at program file so and so. Basically, the exception which we are getting is because we are not giving command line arguments and we are trying to access this args of 0. So let us say we close it. Now let us see how to provide this command line argument. Go to Solution Explorer, you can see on the right hand side, or else you can always go to View and choose the option Solution Explorer. Come here, right click on the project, go to Properties, and you will find here on the left hand side tabs, out of which you have to select the tab Debug, and in Debug here you have the option of giving command line argument. Let us give 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 is first command line argument, 2 is second command line argument, 3 is third command line argument, and 4th is fourth command line argument. In other words, args of 0, args of 1, args of 2, args of 3. In all, 4 command line arguments. Now let us run the program. Control F5, we'll get hello 1. Hello 1 means args of 0 has been consumed here. But now, if I want to have, so can I, okay. We clearly understand here is every command line argument is separated by space. But what if I want to have a command line argument which must have space within it? Simple option. Simply put all this in quotes. So this whole string will become now args of 0. So hello Sandeep Soni. Of course, that's my name. So this is how we provide command line arguments. And how do we give? How do we get command line arguments in an application? Here we get it in the form of main. So I hope you are now very clear on what is the importance of this command line arguments. Any thoughts here? You can email me. Any questions you may have, you can always email me. I'll be more than happy to respond to your doubts. So this is Solution Explorer, where we can see the solution. This is the project, only one project we have in our solution, and under this solution we have got program.cs. As of now we are not really concerned about things like properties here. We'll learn about them in future. Then now, yeah, how to give command line arguments at command prompt. Let's go to the command prompt again. Probably we have already have it here. Now run the application. My first console app space 1, 2, 3. You see, we get the same output. So we can give command line arguments in studio. We can give command line arguments even at the command prompt. So this is the older instance running. Let us close it. This we don't need anymore. We are fine here. So let us go back to our agenda. We have seen here what is the importance of main, the entry point of an application. And we are already on to now working with different forms of main. Before we go further, let us read the notes what I have prepared for you. It's like a summary of whatever we have covered so far. A solution is a collection of programs. One solution can have many projects, and every project added to the solution can be of same language or can be of different language. The choice is ours. Of course, as of now in our solution we have only one project. The solution file has an extension .sln. The project is a collection of files including source code. That means if you are doing a Visual Basic project, it will be .vb files. If you are doing C# project, .cs files. And you will see as we progress further, one project can have many files of source code, resources, RESX files. We can have configuration files, .config files, and many other types of files can be there in the project. The project file has the extension. If you are doing Visual Basic, vb proj, and if you are doing C#, cs proj. A project when built, a build process, always remember, is compilation and linking. Generates a exe or DLL as an output, which is called as P. Now, what kind of circumstances we get DLL? See, as of now, we are developing a console-based application. So, what we got is exe. When we develop a class library